Right.
At 99 seconds, you got to be considering me. You got to be considering timer.
No, call it another meter, man.
Yeah. I think timer is super important.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, cool to see that game being played a little bit differently and a little more interestingly. I agree with you. It's not going to be for everybody, but I like it now. Well, more so anyway. I still think it has some issues, but I'm definitely getting to the point where I'm appreciating it more. So we got Skullgirls up. You can hear the music. This is going to be top 8. We're starting off now.
Shouts out to Mike Z.
Yeah, hopefully Mike Z's watching this thing.
He is.
Oh, he is? Oh, yeah, he is. There you go.
So this is our loser's bracket. First game, it's iNerd and Moons. Then on the other side of the loser's bracket, it'll be me versus Sarabella.
And that bracket is actually online at civilwar.challenge.com/skullgirls. You can go check out what's happening over there. Oh, they're going to do actual... Okay, I was going to say, button checks are not necessary in this game. Okay.
Noobs. Yo. I was like, yo, IRC on the projector?
What?
That was Team Spooky.
Dun, dun, dun. God, the music is so amazing.
I love it.
You know what I've done sometimes? Is just literally turn the game on, go into character select, and just walk away.
Yeah, this
and
is
just like have it on. It's like my ambiance.
This is the only game where you can do that. Every other game is like super irritating to hear the character select screen.
Freaking cross-teching. God. I'm never going to get used to that music. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, I was listening to the MVC2 music today. Just the original stuff from the stages. I was like, this stuff wasn't even that bad, especially compared to stuff like Cross Tekken.
Oh, that's a cool note. Thanks, EastML. So Fireball, just random note. Ryu can confirm into Super from a Fireball all the way across the screen on incoming character. All right, Skullgirls now. So Valentine and Parasol versus Solo Parasol.
Don't think iNerd has put in a ton of work yet in this game, but he's made his way through to the finals.
I know he hasn't, because I hung out with him yesterday, and he said he was actually kind of surprised to get in. He felt he was lucky. Recovers immediately. A lot of people are still not recovering on that after the air fierce from Parasol. A lot of people are getting comboed afterwards, but you don't need to be.
Huh.
Oh, overhead!
I think that he actually was just holding back with a jab. He didn't want that overhead. That was an easy hit confirm. But I've seen that mistake from Parasols, such as myself.
Mm-hmm. Had some damage on the assist there. Been pretty close so far, Parasol backing off.
Yeah. I mean,
trying to set out tiers.
iNerd has the lead, but he can't get too comfortable. Dashes right in with that overhead and a snapback.
He wants to take the assist out. Oh, it missed.
No.
There was a bounce.
Yeah. Just didn't get him in that reel that he was in.
Oh, overhead. Look at this corner pressure here from Parasol. She is so strong at that. Her corner pressure is one of the best.
Going up. Oh, just gets the explosion.
I guess that was enough. Sets out tiers. And now Valentine by herself. She can have some problems getting in. She doesn't have cover.
He can super something in between that if she has something invincible enough. Not sure about Valentine in particular, but...
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yo, you can do EKG through.
iNerd probably just not familiar, but that's not the most abusable tactic. But Parasol's going to get it that time, and the size one damage.
Yeah, characters do more damage and have more life if they're solo.
Yeah. And if the size one characters are going to be viable, it's definitely because of that damage that they can do.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, obviously, you're giving up assists. You're giving up DHCs. See, you're not giving yourself as many options, but more damage.
Yeah, and I've seen some guys already working on 3v1, 100% combos, trying to do that 26k.
Right. Val, gotta try to get in here. She's really not set up her mix-up game. She's a... Ooh.
Gotta punish that.
Yes. Oh, no, and too far away.
Oh, no.
Too far for the Crouching Fierce.
Yeah.
And that opens up a ton of damage here from Parasol. Here comes Moons.
Nice.
Oh, no.
He's already used his OTG.
That's right. Yeah, limit of one OTG per combo. Oh, blown up by the assist, but a little late on the conversion.
Oh, easy punish.
Oh, nice. Taking the shot dash up, yep.
This is exactly what Moons wanted anyway.
Oh,
he wanted
reset.
To hurt Parasol. Oh, God.
Didn't have any more meter. All All right, so he's got Val, and this is the team that he wants. Val, with Parasol Assist, beats the assist before it gets the invincibility. You do have a couple frames of vulnerability as it's coming in. Parasol has a ton of life here for Moon.
And we haven't seen Einar go for any grabs at all, and Valentine does get a combo off of those.
She has a sick grab. Okay, now's a chance for the OTG.
He's got to reset.
I think you're right. But he's going to be able to do significant damage first. Oh, there it is. Great jump, great jump. He scoped it out just like you did.
Okay.
Not going to be a ton of damage because it's level 2 versus level 1. Size 2 versus size 1.
So plenty of time left, but really, what does iNerd have left in the tank? A lot of guys going with just the Parasol, mainly as an assist.
Chip. Neither one has meter right now. Trying to fight away. I'm not sure what iNerd expects is going to happen
he
here.
He can't do this. He can't sit here and throw fireballs against a character with more life.
Come on now.
Oh, taste of his own medicine, but that's not enough damage. And
he
this
didn't
is
get
not
the combo.
Safe.
Wow. He didn't get it.
Yeah, that's
that would have been
an
awesome comeback, but he didn't quite get it, and iNerd is out. That was losers, I think. Hey, that was losers, right? Yeah, so iNerd's done. Can I check out the bracket here? Okay, so up next, we're going to have Ski Sonic versus Nerd Josh. Like I said, Josh was super confident coming into this, but he is in loser's bracket. He told me that his loss was something he should not have.